Sunil Narine is like a raging bull in Spain. Put him against a red t-shirt and he goes nuts. Kings 11 Punjab and him have had like a great love relationship. Every time he plays against them, he goes nuts. Take a look at that 2012, 2013.
I remember that first game. And it's a strange one because it was his second match, his first match playing in Kolkata. Hmm. Got 5 wickets, just bamboozled them totally.
Yeah.
And somehow he managed to contrive to lose that match. You know who the guy got Punjab across the line?
Who was it?
A certain Piyush Chawla.
Oh, we spoke about him as well. Wow.
Then Mohali, he did really well in Mohali in 2013. Again took a hat-trick. We lost that match as well. 2014, of course, Kolkata won their second title. He was at the non-strikers end. He just come in there again. Great. You know, he was there at a very important time. But he... 2017 was an interesting one where he just... That was the thing that actually changed how KKR played. That opening, putting him in the opening slot is what changed everything. And that, I think, has been a huge adjustment. It's worked very well for KKR for 2 years. I suspect it's now the end of that experiment. 2017, 2018, maybe 2019. Shaun, you think it's run its course, you know, this opening?
Yeah, the one thing you don't forget as a player when you're in those teams is people who have performed well against you. And when they come to the crease, you all look around and just say, please, let it not be his day again. He can't surprise us with like 5 catches or something this time around. But yeah, it has been an experiment which I was very surprised at when they went to it, and it worked so well because left hand in combination, and he hit the ball, and it, because he played at the top of the order, it gave them such depth in their batting because one of their recognised batsmen would come in at 6 and 7, so even if they got themselves into trouble, they had that person to help them out. But I think they worked out how he approaches it, and you know, it's a sort of a game plan that you can adjust to and understand and get the bowlers to restrict him in certain ways. So you're right, he might need to just reinvent himself, come up with the odd extra shot and a different way he's going to play. But his fearless approach against the spinners has always been key, and I don't think people are bowling spinners to him that much.
Yeah, absolutely. You know what advantage it gave them was, Chris Lynn's not a great player of spin, especially early in the innings. You know, he doesn't like, you know, the field in and, you know, the ball just not coming onto him. So what happens is with Sunil Narine, teams were hesitant to throw in a spinner because all Chris had to do was rotate strike and let Sunil have a whack at the spinners.
Yeah.
Now that, if this changes today, for example, if Shubman and he walk out today, expect a Murugan Ashwin or expect somebody out there, maybe one side they'll swing it, because see, Andrew Tai is a frontline bowler. He's not going to bowl in the first 6. I mean, he normally never will bowl in the first 6. He'll come in late. So somebody up there, expect them to go slow up front. And that's something that with Sunil Narine there, they wouldn't have dared ever.
No, and in fact, the last game, he took Varun Chakravarti for 24 runs.
He took Varun Chakravarti not for 24 over. Runs, he took Varun Chakravarti's career. After that, Varun Chakravarti hasn't shown himself.
Chakravarti, it's already in past tense. Yeah.
And this was the man who was supposed to have 8 new variations of bowling.
Yeah.
So unfortunately, I of course, jokes aside, I believe he's been injured, but I think it's more than physically he's been injured. You know, after that onslaught,
but I think cricket's an unfair game.
He'll be seeing a Trinidad in his dreams.
In his defence, he has 8 variations, there are only 6 balls in an over. Rishabh had 2 more, he'd have got him out. He'd saved the other 2 there.